Ladies and gentlemen, card test number 3 is sponsored by our main sponsors, KO Media and Andrew Cowley Construction. We are in the lightweight division. Would you please welcome, making his entrance to the ring, all the way from the capital of Hungary, Budapest, here is Zoltan Horvath. Ladies and gentlemen, another undefeated boxer from Leeds again. Here is Justin Newell. Ladies and gentlemen, this contest is for 3-minute rounds of boxing in the lightweight division. Introducing to you firstly, boxing out of the blue corner, wearing the sky blue shorts trimmed with white. At the weight, he scaled 10 stone 2 pounds. Tonight is his 31st professional contest, hailing from Hungary's capital, Budapest, presenting Zoltan Horvath. And opposing him, boxing out of the red corner, wearing the black leather shorts, trimmed with white, pink and yellow. At the weight, he scaled 9 stone, 11 and a half pounds. His perfect unblemished record consists of 7 contests, 7 wins. Hailing from Leeds, he has an international master's belt, presenting the undefeated Justin Newell. Timekeeper once again, Jim McKellen-Patrick, and the referee once more, John Latham from Bury, for 3-minute rounds.
Okay, Justin Newell from Leeds again. These Leeds boys are really
helping. Leeds are turning out tonight, aren't they? You know, and he's got an international master's belt there, which is nice to see. You know, hopefully it's the first belt of many.
He's 7-0 as well, so he's got a good record.
And he come out to a bit of Gabrielle. Oh, he's a bit classy, isn't it?
Looks nice and relaxed in a corner.
Rise again, very appropriate.
Second up, round one.
Okay, Newell in the black shorts. Takes centre of the ring straight away, sticks the jab out.
He's got, as you can see, it's obvious height and reach advantage on the Horvath that Newell has on him. You know, just be good to see if he uses that high reach, which he is.
Nice straight punches.
Nice straight punches. Nice right hand, counter right hand over the top.
Good movement. He snapped, start of the round. Straight in, straight out.
Got caught with a right there himself.
Ooh, nice right hand to the body.
Oh,
just holding that chin a little bit. I just want to tuck that chin down there. Newell.
As we said before, you know, he's going to be looking for a big performance tonight.
Yeah.
He's going to want to, you know, make Campbell look at him, or, you know, well, Campbell's at a slightly higher level at the moment, obviously, but...
You're talking to Luke Campbell?
Yeah.
There's a little bit of rivalry going back from the Leeds lead.
Yeah, want to make Campbell sit up and take notice, you know.
So Newell fighting out the red corner. Again, trained by Joe Pennington.
He's Pennington and lads, you know, there's a lot of emphasis on the jab, I've noticed, and the basics are down quite well.
A little bit dangerous with the head from Horvath there. Shorter opponent, yeah, but came in with the head there blatantly. Referee was straight onto that. Oh, nice
good
right hand.
Shot
nice,
there.
Yeah, good counter punch, counter right hand then from Newell. That's what I think with Newell. He doesn't have to go looking for this guy. This guy will come to him. You know, he just wants to sit on his punches like he's doing. Throwing them nice counters. Dropping that. Oh, nice left up. Like I say, he doesn't need to go looking for this guy. This guy's coming to him. He's got the height and he's got the reach. Just drop them nice counters in as he is doing. Nice jab, nice left hook.
He is 7-0 at the moment, Justin. Again, won all his fights on points. So I think he feels like he wants to make a statement tonight. He looks like he's kind of wanting to put his foot down and get this guy out of there, really.
I was just about to say, and he threw it, as I was about to say, actually, the right uppercut's the punch for Newell on the... I think just a counter right uppercut as Horvath coming forward. He threw it then, but unfortunately it missed. But that's a shot to look for.
Good first round, that quality first round. Yeah. Rob, how difficult is it fighting, you know, opponents that are a lot shorter than you?
Yeah, I mean, I prefer that, you know what I mean? But he can be, you know, he's got a nice jab, he's got the reach on him. You know, we tried that right uppercut then, which is nice to see. You know, and if you can time that right uppercut as they're walking onto it, like I say, you don't need to go looking for them, they're walking onto you. You know, I preferred the shorter guy, to be honest. I wouldn't say I struggled with taller guys, but I preferred smaller or guys in the same height. You know, and you can just work that uppercut on him. You don't need to go looking for him. You know, we just settled into that round nice. You know, I'm sure his coaches will be telling him, you know, don't go looking for him. Let him come on to you. If it works out right up a bit nice, I think, you know, we can see how we're walking onto it. How far, sorry.
Second out, round two.
A nice control first round, and, you know, hopefully give it
round
some
two.
More of the same for round two.
Yeah, Justin Newell fighting out of the red corner from Leeds. Straight away on the jab, sticks the left and right into the face of Horvath.
And the thing is with the Horvath as well, he's the shorter guy and he's coming in with his head now lower even more so. So if you just time that right uppercut, but it's more like a bit of a uppercut combolo punch.
Yeah.
If you timed it right, you know, he could walk right onto it, Horvath. Nice jab.
Needs to get off the ropes, nicely turn away.
Doesn't want to be boxing on the back foot.
Great shot to the body. Horvath's not coming here to roll over, has he?
He's come to a fight, you know, he's having a go, he's coming forward.
Nice job from Newell, and again.
You know, and he looks tough. I mean, usually the Europeans are pretty tough, you know, and they do come to a fight and they come to give it a go, which is nice to see. He just, as you see again, he just tried that right uppercut, just missed by a whisker. But, you know, at least he's settling into throwing that a little bit more often.
Nice work from the centre of the ring.
Nice right hand to the body.
You know, I feel like I'm repeating myself a little bit, but I've been very... impressed with the basics shown tonight from all the boxers, you know. Particularly at the moment, you know, he's coming across with the 1-2s, you know, and he's showing really that the jab is such an important weapon. He's not giving Horvath any room to get in, you know. He's just coming forward, but he's not throwing too much. And
it's nice and controlled from Newell. He's, you know, nice controlled boxing. He's getting behind his jab. He's trying that right uppercut now and again. You know, he's having success with it at times. You know, missing with it a couple of times, but it's nice to see, nice and controlled. Throwing the counter punches, you know, we can see this guy's tough. You know, when he's come to fight, and you know, he's not saying he's not stoppable, but like, you know, sometimes he's just like, he's not being disheartened by, you know, the fact that he's come to fight and he's a durable fighter, just working nicely behind his punches.
You can almost tell though, if the more Newell keeps that jab popping in his face, he's taking out.
And there's that right up again. Time that nice, yeah. You know, and it's a good scoring right up a punch.
A left and a right. Beautiful uppercut. That was up,
yeah, top. Beautiful left uppercut. He's right there. And like I say, yeah, the uppercuts are the punches. I mean, he's working well with his jab. As you can see, the straight right hand over the top's not having too much success with, which you're going to struggle with a shorter guy sometimes on landing that right hand over the top. He wants to just keep hopping behind his jab and keep trying that right uppercut, as he is doing. That left uppercut that he scored at the end of that round was nice as well. So it just goes to show that the uppercuts, you know, with a favourable shot.
Do you think that's what Joe Pennington will be telling him in the corner?
Yeah,
now?
That's what he should be telling him now. You know, just time you, keep popping your jab, keep him at distance. As he comes, drop the right uppercut in or the left uppercut.
Yeah, like I say, these Leeds boys have really saved the show tonight.
Yeah, they're boxing well, yeah.
And it looks, you know, like they really want
nice boxing, you know. It's nice to see in general the boxing scores that they've got, you know. They're not just rushing, they're like this, you know, to me they're like seasoned pro, the way they're settling into the boxing. It's quite good to see, to be honest.
Yeah, absolutely.
Straight back on that jab as he comes out.
There's that right uppercut again.
That's what he needs to do, just keep him on the end of that jab, don't let him get anywhere near.
Oh, nice little flurry from you. You see what I mean? He doesn't have to go looking for him, does he? He's walking onto him all the time. He's just throwing his punches. Nice flowing punches.
I think the only danger he's got is sore hands at the minute, to be honest.
Yeah.
I like the fact he's not dropping his hands.
Good left
up,
yeah. Yeah, he's staying nice and composed. Popping that jab.
Good body shot there.
Yeah. Ooh, right uppercut, which missed by him.
Still looks composed now, well, he's not.
And it's good to see he's not wasting many punches either.
That's what I'm saying, you know, yeah, every nice punch,
nice and controlled. Every punch that he's throwing, not that he's had a few misses, but, you know, he's not going out for leather. He's staying nice and controlled. Every punch he's throwing, he's making it count, which is good to see. Nice run, nice hand over the top.
Right up around the corner. And a left up
to
the body.
Beautiful left up to the body. He picked that really well then.
Starting to pick his shots now.
Yeah,
beautiful.
Picked that left up to the body. Nice again.
Saw the ribcage shake there a little bit.
Just be nice to see him get back to like trying that, the left or the right uppercuts, Horvath coming in, because as we said earlier, he was having success with them. He seems to have lightened up with the uppercuts.
Hit on the break there. Just getting a warning from the referee for hitting on the break.
Oh, Shred that left hook to the body again.
He's looking for that shot. It's hurting Horvath, that one.
Yeah,
it's
taking nice punch.
Last 10 seconds of the round. He's doing the right thing as well, Robin, is it? But you know, when he gets in close, just tying over.
He's doing a good job, you know. He's keeping him at distance. When Horvath does get in close, he's tying him up. You know, that's where going to be the danger position for Newell, is like, you know, let Horvath trying to work, work on the inside where he wants to be, and he's doing a good job. He's tying him up, not letting him get off with the shot, stepping back, pushing him away, and getting behind the jab again, which is, it's good. Good display boxing.
Okay. We're approaching the fourth and final round of this lightweight fight. Justin Newell from Leeds in the red corner.
Leeds in Yorkshire's becoming a bit of a hotbed of talent at the moment.
You know, it's his fourth and final round now. It's nice to see him just step on the gas a little. He boxed well, don't get me wrong. He boxed out of his skin. I wondered if he'll just step up a little bit now, maybe take the fight to Horvath.
The first time Newell's fought outside of Yorkshire, actually. His first time outside of Yorkshire, so I'm sure he wants to put on a show. On the road, first time on the road. Let's end it with a stoppage.
Been a question to you, Barks. Do you think he's done enough to maybe unsettle Luke Campbell?
Well, I mean, he's putting a great performance tonight. You know, it's. You know, obviously, we're going to have to wait till the end of the fight to see how it pans out. But I think, you know, he's definitely made a statement tonight. He's fought beautifully. Great movement. Great on the attack, and he's doing great when he needs to tie him up, so yeah. And this is great, Rob, as well, for the guys. You know, we were talking earlier on, these guys need exposure, and the stuff that we've done here, Black Flash promotion today.
Exactly. You know, and he's come out and he's putting on a good display of boxing. He's in with a tough customer in Horvath. You know, like I say, he's European, he's tough, you can see he's tough. He's landed some good body shots, good head shots. You know, and he's kept control of the fight. You know, and it's good to see. You know, and you need to have these fights. I mean, we all want to see a stoppage at times, don't get me wrong. But when you're seeing a good display of boxing in each round, you're happy with that. And you could, you know, you need these rounds under your belt for when you start stepping up in classes opponents, or when you start stepping up, you know, for greater honors, British titles, European titles, and world titles.
Bit of Rafael's tactics there.
Good shot.
And again to the body.
He wobbled Horvath then with that left hook.
He's opening up a bit more, Horvath there. A bit last chance saloon, you know, he's going for it and getting tagged.
Newell's picking these shots beautifully. Last 30 seconds here. Light hook again. Left, right, and again to the body.
You know, and credit where credit's due. You know, Horvath still making a fight of it. He's coming forward. You know, he shipped some punishment there. He stuck some stiff shots. As we can see, he's durable. You know, and he's still making a play for it. He's still having a go. He's not winning the fight. But, you know, he's having a go, and it's good to see.
Of course, yeah.
You know, and from Newell's point of view, he's landed some, you know, that can be disarming at times. You're landing some of your best punches, hard, stiff punches, and your opponent's taking him, you know, and coming back a bit. You know, so he's boxing well. He's kept nice and controlled, you know, and it looks like he's going to see the fight out. Yeah, and that's a nice point. That looks, you know, like a nice point win.
Joel Pennington and Newell just congratulating the boys in the blue corner. Hungary, like you say, Rob, he come over and he put up a great front. So he, you know, he weren't never winning the fight.
Yeah, he was never winning the fight, but you know, it was a good test for Newell. You know, he made him box. He made him, you know, and he's made him box. He's made him use his jab, his uppercuts. He, you know, a full variation of punches there. You know, some left hooks to the head at times, and he, you know, he placed them nicely. So you know, it was a good little test for him tonight. You know, he's got the rounds under his belt. You know, I think he's going to go on to win the fight. I thought, you know, he's won every round. But, you know, at least Horvath made the fight of it. He comes to fight, give it a go. You know, and it's good. You know, it's good for boxing. It's good for boxing.
Ladies and gentlemen, after four rounds of lightweight action, referee John Latham has scored this contest 40 points to 36 pounds for your winner. Hailing from Leeds, now defeated in 8 professional contests, Justin Newell. The final round of applause, please, for Hungary Zoltan Horvath.
Yeah. And as we predicted, you know, yeah, it was a clear four rounds, four points win.
Justin!
No, but like, you know, there's Horvath has been a league, you know, he's not disgraced himself, like we say, he's come to fight, given.
Not at all. Takes him, like you say, 2-8-0. First time fighting outside of Yorkshire, so he's got that as well, because that can be a bit of a.
Yeah, you know, it's not his own crowd as such, you know, he's a bit nearer to home than Horvath is, but like you say, you know, the crowd seemed happy with that, we were happy with it, I'm sure he'll be happy with it. He boxed well.
Okay, we're going to go.
Good pleasing fight.
Yeah, we're going to go to ringside with Terry Dooley.
1 minute. Not recording that, is it?
Hi, Justin, Terry Dooley, how's it going? You're putting a good performance there. How did you feel about it?
Well, it's first time I boxed since March last year, so I was instructed to get in there and get some rounds done. You know, you always put yourself down. I could have done a little bit better, but that's boxing. Should have done it while you're in there, but hey-ho, that's it.
I mean, as you say, you'd like to get some knockouts, but you needed rounds in the bank, so do you feel comfortable with what you did tonight?
Yeah, I feel comfortable. I see what the team says, you know what I mean, but I thought we were all right. The kid was tough, you know what I mean? A bit shorter, so it was hard to get my shots off properly. He kept coming up, so I just had to tie him up a little touch.
And in terms of your future, I believe that there was talk of a Luke Campbell fight. What was the situation with that one? Did he want you to come in at a weight you weren't comfortable with, and do you think that's a fight you could take next year?
Well, what happened there is we got a phone call saying, oh, you can take the fight in 9 days if you want in Hull. Want you to lose half a stone. The money was shit, you know what I mean? So why not get the fight on properly, give us a fair training camp, make it a 50-50 fight, and like I've told you before, I'll go into that fight an underdog and I'll come out a star. If they want that fight, Luke Campbell, let's get it on. I'll be fit, you'll be ready, I'm coming for you.
And you're a pretty big lad, do you think given time and notice you can get yourself right the way down to lightweight and still be effective?
Not a problem. I got down to 9 stone 11 and a half today, do you know what I mean? And to be fair, this was a short notice fight. You know, we had about 8 days notice. So I got down to the weight all right, so proper dieting, a proper camp, I'll be on my game.
So you're basically saying if the notice is right and everything, you're happy to take that fight and are really looking to try and take it next year?
Definitely. I'll take that fight in Hull in his own backyard. I'm confident, my team's confident, and that's all I need. If they believe in me, I believe in them.
And they must have a lot of belief, and you must have a lot of belief in yourself, because Campbell's looked pretty sensational so far as a pro. What's your assessment of him?
I wouldn't say special as a pro. I'd say he was a special amateur. He got the, managed. He got the Olympic gold. Not taking no credit away from him. He was an excellent and an outstanding amateur in that Olympic Games. But as a pro, I don't think he's turned over well. Not at all.
And just finally, when's your next outing? Are you looking to get something in the early in the new year?
Yeah, well, I'll be training over the Christmas period. And fingers crossed, you know, we'll be out in new year.
And what are you doing about the belt? Are you looking to get a defence under your belt at some point?
Let's see what happens. You know what I mean? We can make the defence. If someone else pops up what's a little bit better, I'm sure we'll take that.
So it must be nice to have options on the table, though.
Oh, definitely. It's something that we haven't really had before. You know what I mean? We've never had an option, bar that Luke Campbell fight with whatever day's notice it was. You know what I mean? It's ridiculous.
Okay, well, thanks for coming over tonight. And
I'd just like to thank Pat Barrett as well. Black Flash Promotions for letting us on the show. You know what I mean? And to everybody in the gym who's helped me. You all know they are, and the sponsors as well. Thank you very much.
And just finally on the show itself, have you ever seen a show like this? Someone put on their first show in such a nice venue and put so much thought into it?
Well, look around you. Everybody seems like they're enjoying themselves. You know, it's a good night. Good night for boxing. Great for Pat to be back in the promotion. Do you know what I mean? And I'm sure we can all work together again and all get on the show again.
Hey, cheers. Best of luck.